हेलो नमस्ते, मायसेल्फ अंकिता श्रेया प्रसाद एंड यू आर लिसनिंग टू अलोंग विद एनसीईआरटी 11th एंड 12th ऑडियो वीडियो बुक प्रेजेंटेड बाय आर्टस्किल पैशन। चैप्टर 7 स्ट्रक्चरल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन इन एनिमल्स। In the preceding chapters, you came across a large variety of organisms, both unicellular and multicellular, of the animal kingdom. In unicellular organisms, all functions like digestion, respiration, and reproduction are performed by a single cell. In the complex body of multicellular animals, the same basic functions are carried out by different groups of cells in a well-organized manner. The body of simple organisms like hydra is made up of different types of cells, and the number of cells in each type can be in thousands. The human body is composed of billions of cells to perform various functions. How do these cells in the body work together? In multicellular animals, a group of similar cells along with intercellular substances perform a specific function. Such an organization is called tissue. You may be surprised to know that all complex animals consist of only 4 basic types of tissues. These tissues are organized in specific proportion and pattern to form an organ-like stomach, lung, heart, and kidney. When two or more organs perform a common function by their physical and or chemical interaction, they together form organ system. Example, digestive system, respiratory system, etc. Cells, tissues, organs, and organ system split up the work in a way that exhibits division of labor and contribute to the survival of the body as a whole. 7.1 Animal tissues. The structure of the cells vary according to their function. Therefore, the tissues are different and are broadly classified into 4 types. First, epithelial. Second, connective. Third, muscular. And fourth, neural. 7.1.1 Epithelial tissues. We commonly refer to an epithelial tissues as epithelium, plural epithelia. This tissue has a free surface which surfaces either a body fluid or the outside environment and thus provides a covering or a lining for some part of the body. The cells are compactly packed with little intercellular matrix. There are 2 types of epithelial tissues, namely simple epithelium and compound epithelium. Simple epithelium is composed of a single layer of cells and functions as a lining of a body cavities, ducts, and tubes. The compound epithelium consists of 2 or more cell layers and has protective function as it does in our skin. On the basis of structural modification of the cells, simple epithelium is further divided into 3 types. These are squamous, cuboidal, columnar. Figure 7.1 Simple epithelium. Squamous, cuboidal, columnar. Columnar cells bearing cilia. The squamous epithelium is made of a single thin layer of flattened cells with irregular boundaries. They are found in the walls of blood vessels and air sacs of lungs and are involved in functions like forming a diffusion boundary. The cuboidal epithelium is composed of a single layer of cube-like cells. This is commonly found in ducts of glands and tubular parts of nephrons in kidney, and its main functions are secretion and absorption. The epithelium of proximal convoluted tubule PCT of the nephron in the kidneys has microvilli. The columnar epithelium is composed of a single layer of tall and slender cells. Their nuclei are located at the base. Free surface may have microvilli. They are found in the lining of stomach and intestine and help in the secretion and absorption. If the columnar or cuboidal cells bear cilia on their free surface, they are called ciliated epithelium. Figure 7.1d. Their function is to move particles or mucus in a specific direction over the epithelium. They are mainly present in the inner surface of hollow organs like bronchioles and fallopian tubes. Some of the columnar or cuboidal cells get specialized for secretions and are called glandular epithelium. Figure 7.2. Glandular epithelium, A. Unicellular, B. Multicellular. They are mainly of two types. Unicellular, consisting of isolated glandular cells, goblet cells of the alimentary canal, and multicellular, consisting of cluster of cells, salivary gland on the basis of the mode of pouring of the secretion glands, are divided into two categories, namely exocrine and endocrine glands. Exocrine gland secretes mucus, saliva, earwax, oil, milk, digestive enzymes, and other cell products. These products are released through ducts or tubes. In contrast, endocrine glands do not have ducts. Their products, called hormones, are secreted directly into the fluid bathing the gland. Compound epithelium is made of more than one layer, multi-layered of cells, and thus has a limited role in secretion and absorption. Figure 7.3. Their main function is to provide protection against chemical and mechanical stresses. They cover the dyed surface of the skin, the moist surface of buccal cavity, pharynx, inner lining of ducts of salivary glands, and of pancreatic ducts. A. All cells in epithelium are held together with little intercellular material. In nearly all animal tissues, specialized junctions provide both structural and functional links between its individual cells. Three types of cell junctions are found in the epithelium and other tissues. These are called as tight, adhering, and gap junctions. Tight junctions help to stop substances from leaking across the tissues. Adhering junctions perform cementing to keep neighboring cells together. Gap junctions facilitate the cells to communicate with each other by connecting the cytoplasm of adjoining cells for rapid transfer of ions, small molecules, and sometimes big molecules. 7.1.2. Connective tissues. Connective tissues are most abundant and widely distributed in the body of complex animals. They are named connective tissues because of their special functions of linking and supporting other tissues, organs of the body. They range from soft connective tissues to specialized types, which include cartilage, bone, adipose, and blood. In all connective tissues except blood, the cells secrete fibers of structural proteins called collagen or elastin. The fibers provide strength, elasticity, and flexibility to the tissues. These cells also secrete modified polysaccharides, which accumulate between cells and fibers and act as matrix ground substrates. Connective tissues are classified into three types. First, loose connective tissue. Second, dense connective tissues. And third, specialized connective tissues. Loose connective tissues has cells and fibers loosely arranged in semi-fluid ground substrates. For example, areolar tissues present beneath the skin. Figure 7.4. Often, it serves as a support framework for epithelium. It contains fibroblasts, cells that produce and secrete fibers. Macrophages and mast cells. Adipose tissues is another type of loose connective tissues located mainly beneath the skin. The cells of these tissues are specialized to store fats. The excess of nutrients which are not used immediately are converted into fats and are stored in these tissues. Fibers and fibroblasts are completely packed in the dense connective tissues. Orientation of fibers shows regular or irregular pattern and are called dense regular and dense irregular tissues. In the dense regular connective tissues, the collagen fiber are present in rows between many parallel bundles of fibers. Tendons, which attach skeleton muscles to bones, and ligaments, which attach one bone to another, are examples of this tissue. Dense irregular connective tissues has fibroblasts and many fibers, mostly collagen, that are oriented differently. Figure 7.5. Dense connective tissues. A. Dense regular. B. Dense irregular. This tissue is present in the skin, cartilage, bones, and blood are various types of specialized connective tissues. The intercellular material of cartilage is solid and pliable and resists compression. Cells of these tissues, chondrocytes, are enclosed in small cavities within the matrix secreted by them. Figure 7.6a. Most of the cartilage in vertebrate embryos are replaced by bones in adults. Cartilage is present in the tip of nose, outer ear joints, between adjacent bones of the vertebral column, limbs, and hands in adults. Bones have hard and non-peelable ground substances rich in calcium salts and collagen fibers, which give bone its strength. Figure 7.6b. It is the main tissue that provides the structural frame to the body. Bone support and protects softest tissues and organs. The bone cells, osteocytes, are present in the species called lacunae. Limb bones such as the long bones of legs serve weight-bearing functions. They also interact with skeletal muscles attached to them to bring about movements. The bone marrow in some bones is the site of production of blood cells. Blood is a fluid connective tissues containing plasma, red blood cells, RBC, white blood cells, WBC, and platelets. Figure 7.6c. It is the main circulating fluid that helps in the transport of various substances. You will learn more about the blood in chapter 17 and 18. Figure 7.6. Specialized connective tissues. A. Cartilage. B. Bone. C. Blood. 7.1.3. Muscle tissue. Each muscle is made up of many long cylindrical fibers arranged in parallel arrays. These fibers are composed of numerous fine fibrils called microfibrils. Muscle fibers contract, shorten in response to stimulation, then relax, lengthen, and return to their uncontracted state in coordinated fashion. Their action moves the body to adjust to the changes in the environment and to maintain the position of the various parts of the body. In general, muscles play an active role in all the movements of the body. Muscles are of three types: skeletal, smooth, and cardiac. Skeletal muscles, tissues is closely attached to skeletal bones. In a typical muscle such as the biceps, straightened stripped skeletal muscle fibers are bundled together in a parallel fashion. Figure 7.7a. A sheath of tough connective tissues encloses several bundles of muscle fibers.
You will learn more about this in chapter 20. The smooth muscle fibers taper at the both ends, fusiform, and do not show striation. Figure 7.7b. Cell junctions hold them together and they are bundled together in a connective tissue. Sheath. The wall of internal organs such as the blood vessels, stomach, and intestine contains this type of muscle tissues. Smooth muscles are involuntary as their functioning cannot be directly controlled. We usually are not able to make it contract merely by thinking about it as we can do with skeletal muscles. Cardiac muscle tissues is a contractile tissue present only in the heart. Cell junctions fuse the plasma membranes of cardiac muscle cells and make them stick together. Figure 7.7c. Communication junctions intercalated discs are some fusion points allow the cells to contact as unit. That is, when one cell receives a signal to contract, its neighbors are also stimulated to contract. Figure 7.7. Muscle tissues. A. Skeletal striated muscle tissues. B. Smooth muscle tissues. C. Cardiac muscle tissues. 7.1.4. Neural tissue. Neural tissue exerts the greatest control over the body's responsiveness to change conditions. Neurons, the unit of neural systems, are excitable cells. Figure 7.8. Neural tissues, neuron with neuroglia. The neuroglial cells, which constitute the rest of the neural system, protect and support neurons. Neuroglia make up more than one half of the volume of neural tissue in our body. When neuron is suitably stimulated, an electrical disturbance is generated, which swiftly travels along its plasma membrane. Arrival of the disturbance at neuron's ending, our output zone triggers events that may cause stimulation or inhibition of adjacent neurons and other cells. You will study the details in chapter 21. 7.2. Organ and organ system. The basic tissues mentioned above organize to form organs, which in turn associate to form organ system in the multicellular organisms. Such an organization is essential for more efficient and better coordinated activities of millions of cells constituting an organism. Each organ in our body is made up of one or more types of tissues. For example, our heart consists of the four types of tissues, that is, epithelial, connective, muscular, and neural. We also notice after some careful study that the complexity in organ and organ system displays certain discernible trend. This discernible trend is called evolutionary trend. You will study the details in class 12. You are being introduced to morphology and anatomy of three organisms at different evolutionary levels to show their organization and functioning. Morphology refers to the study of form or externally visible features. In the case of plants or microbes, the term morphology precisely means only this. In case of animals, this refers to the external appearance of the organs or the part of the body. The word anatomy conventionally is used for the study of morphology of internal organs in the animals. You will learn the morphology and anatomy of earthworm, cockroach, and frog, representing invertebrates and vertebrates. 7.3. Earthworm. Earthworm is a reddish-brown terrestrial invertebrate that inhabits the upper layer of the moist soil. During daytime, they live in burrows made by boring and swallowing the soil. In the gardens, they can be traced by their fecal deposition known as worm casting. The common Indian earthworms are Ferritima and Lumbricus. 7.3.1 Morphology. Earthworms have long cylindrical body. The body is divided into more than 100 short segments, which are similar. Metamers about 100 to 120 in numbers. The dorsal surface of the body is marked by dark median mid-dorsal line. Dorsal blood vessels along the longitudinal axis of the body. The ventral surface is distinguished by the presence of genital opening pores. Anterior end consists of the mouth and prostomium, a lobe which serves as covering for the mouth and as which to force open cracks in the soil into which the earthworm may crawl. The prostomium is sensory in function. The first body segment is called the peristomium buccal segment, which contains the mouth in a mature worm segments. 14 to 16 are covered by prominent dark band of glandular tissues called cilitellum. Thus, the body is divisible into three prominent regions: pre-cilitellar, cilitellar, and post-cilitellar segments. Figure 7.9. Body of earthworm. A. Dorsal view. B. Ventral view. C. Lateral view. Showing mouth opening. Four pairs of spermatical apertures are situated on the ventrolateral sides of intersegmental grooves, that is, 5th to 9th segments. A single female genital pore is present in the mid-ventral line of 4th segment. A pair of male genital pores are present on the ventrolateral sides of the 18th segment. Numerous minute pores are called nephridiospores open on the surface of the body. In each body segment except the first, last and cilitellum, there are rows of S-shaped setae embedded in the epidermal pits in the middle of each segment. Setae can be extended or retracted, their principal role in locomotion. 7.3.2 Anatomy. The body wall of the earthworm is covered externally by a thin non-cellular cuticle below which is the epidermis. Two muscle layers, circular and longitudinal, and are innermost coelomic epithelium. The epidermis is made up of the single layer of columnar epithelium cells, which contain secretory gland cells. The alimentary canal is a straight tube and runs between first to last segment of the body. Figure 7.10. A terminal mouth opens into the buccal cavity 1 to 3 segments, which leads into muscular pharynx. A small narrow tube, esophagus 5 to 7 segments, continues into muscular gizzards 8 to 9 segments. It helps in grinding the soil particles and decaying leaves, etc. The stomach extends from 9 to 14 segments. The foot of the earthworm is decaying leaves and organic matter mixed with soil. Calciferous gland present in the stomach neutralize the humic acid present in the humans. Intestine starts from the 15 segments onwards and continues till the last segment. A pair of short and conical intestinal cilia project from the intestine on the 26th segment. The characteristic feature of the intestine after 26th segment except the last 23rd to 25th segment is the presence of internal median flood of dorsal wall called typsol. This increases the effective area of absorption in the intestine. The alimentary canal opens to the exterior by a small rounded aperture called anus. The ingested organic rich soil passes through the digestive tract, which digestive enzymes break down complex food into smaller absorbable units. These simpler molecules are absorbed through intestinal membranes and are utilized. Ferritima exhibits a closed type of blood vascular system consisting of blood vessels, capillaries and heart. Figure 7.11. Due to closed circulatory system, blood is confined to heart and blood vessels. Contractions keep body circulating in one direction. Smaller blood vessels supply the gut, nerve cord and the body wall. Blood glands are present on the 4th, 5th and 6th segments. They produce blood cells and hemoglobin, which is dissolved in blood plasma. Blood cells are phagocytic in nature. Earthworms lack specialized breathing devices. Respiratory exchange occurs through moist body surface into their bloodstream. The excretory organs occur as segmentally arranged coiled tubules called nephridia, singular nephridium. There are of three types. First, septal nephridia present on both the sides of intersegmental septa of segment 15 to the last that open into intestine. Second, integumentary nephridia attached to lining of the body wall of segment 3 to the last that open on the body surface, and third, pharyngeal nephridia present as three paired tufts in the 4th, 5th, 6th segments. Figure 7.12. These different types of nephridia are basically similar in structure. Nephridia regulate the volume and composition of the body fluids. A nephridium starts out as a funnel that collects excess fluid from coelomic chamber. The funnel connects with a tubular part of nephridium, which delivers the waste through a pore to the surface in the body wall into the digestive tubes. Nervous system is basically represented by ganglia arranged segment-wise. On the ventral pain nerve cord, the nerve cord in the anterior region, third and fourth segments. Bifurcates laterally, encircling the pharynx, and join the cerebral ganglia dorsally to form a nerve ring. The cerebral ganglia, along with other nerves in the ring, integrate sensory input as well as command muscular responses of the body. Sensory system does not have eyes but does possess light and touch-sensitive organs, receptor cells, to distinguish the light insensitives and to feel the vibration in the ground. Worms have specialized chemoreceptors, taste receptors, which react to chemical stimuli. These sense organs are located on the anterior part of the worm. Earthworm is hermaphrodite, bisexual, that is, testes and ovaries are present in the same individual. Figure 7.13. There are two pairs of testes present in the 10th and 11th segments. Their vasa differentia run up to the 18th segment, where they join the prostatic duct. Two pairs of accessory glands are present, one pair each in the 17th and 19th segments. The common prostate and spermatic duct vasa differentia opens into the exterior by a pair of male genital pore on the ventrolateral side of the 18th segment. Four pairs of spermatheca are located in 6 to 9 segments, one pair in each segment. They receive and store spermatozoa during copulation. One pair of ovaries is attached at the intersegmental septum of the 12th and 13th segments. Ovarian funnels are present beneath the ovaries, which continue into oviduct, joined together and open on the ventral side as a single median female genital pore on the 14th segment. A mutual exchange of sperm occurs between two worms during mating. One worm has to find another worm and they mature, juxtaposing opposite gonadal opening, exchanging packets of sperms called spermatospores. Mature sperms and egg cells and nutritive fluid are deposited in cocoons produced by the gland cells of cilitellum. Fertilization and development occurs within the cocoons, which are deposited in soil. The ova, eggs are fertilized by the sperm cells within the cocoon, which this slips off the worm and is deposited in or on the soil. The cocoon holds the worm embryos. After about 3 weeks, each cocoon produces 2 to 20 baby worms with an average of 4. Development of earthworm is direct, that is, there is no larva formed. Earthworms are known as friends of farmers because they make burrows in the soil and make it porous, which help in respiration and penetration of the developing plant roots. The process of increasing fertility of soil by the earthworm is called vermicomposting. They are also used as bait in game fishing. 7.4. Cockroach. Cockroaches are brown or black-bodied animals that are included in class Insecta of phylum Arthropoda. Bright yellow, red and green colored cockroaches have also been reported in tropical regions. Their size ranges from 1 by 4 inches to 3 inches, 0.6 to 7.6 centimeter, and have long antenna, legs and flat extension of the upper body wall that conceals head. They are nocturnal omnivores that live in damp places throughout the world. They have become residents of human homes and thus are serious pests and vectors of several diseases. 7.4.1 Morphology. The adults of the common species of cockroach, Periplanta americana, about 34 to 53 mm long, with the wings that extend beyond the tip of the abdomen in males. The body of the cockroach is segmented and divisible into three distinct regions: head, thorax and abdomen. Figure 7.14. The entire body is covered by a hard chitinous exoskeleton, brown in color. In each segment, exoskeleton has hardened planes called sclerites, tegrites dorsally and sternites ventrally, that are joined to each other by a thin flexible articular membrane, arthrodial membrane. Figure 7.14. External features of cockroach. Head is a triangular in shape and lies anteriorly at right angles to the longitudinal body axis. It is formed by the fusion of 6 segments and shows great mobility in all directions due to flexible neck. Figure 7.15. The head capsule bears a pair of compound eyes. A pair of thread-like antenna arises from membranous sockets lying in fronts of eyes. Antenna have sensory receptors that help in monitoring the environment. Anterior end of the head bears appendages forming biting and chewing type of the mouth parts. The mouth parts consisting of a labrum, upper lip, a pair of mandibles, a pair of maxillae and a labium, lower lips, a median flexible lobe acting as tongue. Hypopharynx lies within the cavity enclosed by the mouth parts. Figure 7.15b. Thorax consists of 3 parts, prothorax, mesothorax and metathorax. The head is connected with thorax by a short extension of the prothorax known as the neck. Each thoracic segment bears a pair of walking legs. The first pair of wings arises from mesothorax and the second pair of from metathorax. 4 wings, mesothoracic called pterygma, are opaque, dark and leathery and cover the hind wings when at the rest. The hind wings are transparent, membranous and are used in flight. The abdomen in both males and females consisting of 10 segments in females. The seventh sternum is boat shape, and together with the eighth and ninth sterna forms a broad or genital pouch whose anterior part contains female gonopore. Spermatical pores and collateral glands in males' genital pouch or chamber slice at the hind end of abdomen bounded dorsally by 9th and 10th sterga and ventrally by the 9th sternum. It contains dorsal anus, ventral male genital pore and gonophoses. Male bear a pair of short, thread-like and anal style which are absent in females. In both sexes, the 10th segment bears a pair of jointed filamentous structure called anal cerci. Figure 7.15. Head region of cockroach. A. Part of head region. B. Mouth parts. 7.4.2. Anatomy. The alimentary canal present in the body cavity is divided into three regions: foregut, midgut, and hindgut. Figure 7.16. The mouth opens into a short tubular pharynx leading to a narrow tubular passage called esophagus. This in turn opens into a sac-like structure called crop used for storing of food. The crop is followed by gizzard or proventriculus. It has an outer layer of thick circular muscles and thick inner cuticle forming six highly chitinous plate called teeth. Gizzards help in grinding the food particles. The entire foregut is lined by cuticle, a ring of 6 to 8 blind tubules called hepatic or gastric cecae is present at the junction of foregut and midgut, which secrete digestive juice. At the junction of midgut and hindgut is present another ring of 100 to 150 yellow-colored thin filamentous morphogen tubules. They help in removal of excretory products from hemolymph. The hindgut is broader than midgut and is differentiated into ileum, colon and rectum. The rectum opens out through anus. Figure 7.16. Alimentary canal of cockroach. Blood vascular system of cockroach is an open type. Figure 7.17. Blood vessels are poorly developed and open into space, hemocoel. Visceral organs located in the hemocoel are bathed in blood. Hemolymph. The hemolymph is composed of colorless plasma and hemocytes. Heart of cockroach consists of elongated muscular tubule lying along mid-dorsal line of thorax and abdomen. It is differentiated into funnel-shaped chambers with ostia on either side. Blood from sinuses enter heart through ostia and is pumped anteriorly to sinuses again. The respiratory system consists of a network of trachea that opens through 10 pairs of small holes called spiracles present on the lateral side of the body. The branching tubules, tracheal tubes subdivided into tracheoles, carry oxygen from the air to all the parts. The opening of the spiracles is regulated by the sphincters. Exchange of gases takes place at the tracheoles by diffusion. Excretion is performed by morphogen tubules. Each tubule is lined by glandular and ciliated cells. They absorb nitrogenous waste products and convert them into uric acid, which is excreted out through the hindgut. Therefore, this insect is called uricotelic. In addition, the fat body, nephrocytes, and mucose glands also help in excretion. The nervous system of cockroach consists of a series of few segmentally arranged ganglia joined by paired longitudinal connectives on the ventral side. Three ganglia lie in the thorax and six in the abdomen. The nervous system of cockroach is spread throughout the body. The head holds a bit of nervous system while the rest is situated along the ventrally belly side part of its body. So now you understand that if the head of cockroaches is cut off, it will still live for as long as 1 week. In the head region, the brain is represented by spora, esophageal ganglion, which supplies nerve to antenna and compound eyes. In cockroach, the sense organs are antennae, eyes, maxillary pulps, labial pulps and cerci, etc. The compound eyes are situated at the dorsal surface of the head. Each eye consists of about 2000 hexagonal amartidia, single amartidium. With the help of several amartida, a cockroach can receive several images of an object. This kind of vision is known as mosaic vision, which more sensitively but less resolution, being common during night, hence called nocturnal vision. Cockroaches are dioecious and both sexes have well developed reproductive organs. Figure 7.18. Male reproductive system consists of a pair of testes, one lying on each lateral side in 4th to 5th abdominal segments. From each testes arises a thin vas deferentia, which opens it to ejaculatory duct through seminal vesicles. The ejaculatory duct opens into male gonopore situated ventral to anus. A characteristic mushroom-shaped gland is present in the 6th to 7th abdominal segments, which functions as an accessory reproductive gland. The external genitalia are represented by male gonophyses or phallomere, chitinous asymmetrical structure surrounding the male gonopore. The sperms are stored in seminal vesicles and are glued together in the form of bundles called spermatophores, which are discharged during copulation. The female reproductive system consists of two large ovaries lying laterally in the 2nd and 6th abdominal segments. Each ovary is formed of a group of 8 ovarian tubules or ovarioles containing a chain of developing ova. Oviducts of each ovary unite into a single median oviduct, also called vagina, which opens into the genital chamber. A pair of spermatheca is present in the 6th segments, which opens into the genital chamber. Sperms are transferred through spermatospores. Their fertilized eggs are encased in capsules called oothecae. Oothecae is a dark reddish to the blackish brown capsule about 3 to 8 millimeters long. They are dropped or glued to a suitable surface, usually in a crack or surface of high relative humidity near a food source. On an average, female produces 9 to 10 oothecae, each containing 14 to 16 eggs. The development of P. americana is purometabolus, meaning there is a development through nymphal stage. The nymphs looks like very much like adults. The nymph grows by molting about 30 times to reach the adult form. The next to the lost nymphal stage has wing pads, but only adult cockroaches have wings. Many species of cockroaches are wild and are of no known economic importance yet. A few species thrive in and around human habitat. They are pests because they spoil food and contaminate it when they smelly excreta. They can transmit a variety of bacterial diseases by contaminating food materials. 7.5. Frogs. Frogs can live both on land and in fresh water and belong to class Amphibia of phylum Chordata. The most common species of frog found in India is Rana tigrina. They do not have constant body temperature. That is, their body temperature varies within the temperature of the environment. Such animals are called cold-blooded or polychiloterms. You might have also noticed the changes in the color of the frog while they are in grasses and on dry land. They have the ability to change the color to hide them from their enemies, camouflage. This protective coloration is called mimicry. You may also know the frogs are not seen during peak summer and winter. During this period, they take shelter in deep burrows to protect them from extreme heat and cold. This is known as summer sleep, estivation, and winter sleep, hibernation, respectively. 7.5.1 Morphology. Have you ever touched the skin of frog? The skin is smooth and slippery due to the presence of mucus. The skin is always maintained in a moist condition. The color of dorsal side of body is generally olive green with dark irregular spots. And the ventral side of the skin is uniformly pale yellow. The frog never drinks water but absorbs it through the skin. Body of a frog is divisible into head and trunk. Figure 7.19. A neck and tail are absent. Above the mouth, a pair of nostrils is present. Eyes are bulged and covered by a nictitating membrane that protects them while in water. On either side of eyes as membranous tympanum, ear receives sound signals. The forelimbs and hind limbs help in swimming, walking, leaping and burrowing. The hind limbs end in 5 digits and they are larger and muscular than forelimbs that end in 4 digits. Feet have webbed digits that help in swimming. Frog exhibits sexual dimorphism. Male frogs can be distinguished by the presence of sound-producing vocal sacs and also a copulatory pad on the first digit of the forelimbs, which are absent in female frogs. 7.5.2 Anatomy. The body cavity of frogs accommodate different organ systems such as digestive, circulatory, respiratory, nervous, excretory and reproductive system with well-developed structure and functions. Figure 7.20. The digestive system consists of alimentary canal and digestive glands. The alimentary canal is short because frogs are carnivores and hence the length of intestine is reduced. The mouth opens into the buccal cavity that leads to the esophagus through pharynx. Esophagus is a short tube that opens into the stomach, which in turn continues as the intestine, rectum, and finally opens outside by the cloaca. Liver secretes bile that is stored in the gallbladder. Pancreas. A digestive gland produces pancreatic juice containing digestive enzymes. Food is captured by the bilobed tongue. Digestion of food takes place by the action of HCl and gastric juice secreted from the walls of the stomach. Partially digested food called chyme is passed from stomach to the first part of the small intestine, the duodenum. The duodenum receives bile from gallbladder and pancreatic juices from the pancreas through a common bile duct. Bile emulsifies fat and pancreatic juices digest carbohydrates and proteins. Final digestion takes place in the intestine. Digested food is absorbed by the numerous finger-like plates in the inner wall of intestine called villi and microvilli. The undigested solid waste moves into the rectum and passes out through cloaca. Frogs respire on land and in water by 2 different methods. In water, skin acts as an aquatic respiratory organ. Cutaneous respiration, dissolved oxygen in the water is exchanged through the skin by diffusion. On land, The buccal cavity, skin and lungs act as the respiratory organs. The respiration by lungs is called pulmonary respiration. The lungs are a pair of elongated pink-colored sac-like structure present in the upper part of the trunk region. Thorax. Air enters through the nostrils in the buccal cavity and then to lungs. During aestivation and hibernation, gaseous exchange takes place to skin. The vascular system of frog is well developed, closed type. Frogs have a lymphatic system also. The blood vascular system involves heart, blood vessels and blood. The lymphatic system consists of lymph channels and lymph nodes. Heart is a muscular structure situated in the upper part of the body cavity. It has three chambers, two atria and one ventricle, and is covered by membrane called pericardium. A triangular structure called sinus venous joins the right atrium. It receives blood through the major veins called vena cava. The ventricle opens into a sac-like conus atrios on the ventral side of the heart. The blood from the heart is carried to all parts of the body by arteries, atrial system. The vein collects blood from the different parts of the body to the heart and forms the venous system. Special venous connection between liver and intestine as well as the kidney and lower parts of the body are present in frogs. The former is called hepatic portal system and the latter is called renal portal system. The body is composed of plasma and cells. The blood cells are RBC, red blood cells, or erythrocytes, WBC, white blood cells, or leukocytes and platelets. RBCs are nucleated and contain red color pigment, namely hemoglobin. The lymph is different from blood. It lacks few proteins and RBCs. The blood carries nutrients, gases, and water to the respective sites during the circulation. The circulation of blood is achieved by pumping action of the muscular heart. The elimination of nitrogenous waste is carried out by a well-developed excretory system. The excretory system consists of a pair of kidneys, ureters, cloaca, and urinary bladder. These are compact, dark red and bean-like structures situated a little posteriorly in the body cavity on both sides of vertebral column. Each kidney is composed of several structural and functional units called uriniferous tubules or nephrons. Two ureters emerge from the kidney in the male frogs. The ureters act as urinogenital ducts which opens into the cloaca. In female, the ureters and oviduct open separately in the cloaca. The thin-walled urinary bladder is present ventral to the rectum, which also open in the cloaca. The frog excretes urea and thus is a ureotelic animal. Excretory waste are carried by blood into the kidney, where it is separated and excreted. The system for control and coordination is highly evolved in the frog. It includes both neural system and endocrine glands. The chemical coordination of various organs of the body is achieved by hormones which are secreted by the endocrine glands. The prominent endocrine glands found in the frog are pituitary, thyroid, parathyroid, thymus, pineal body, pancreatic islets, adrenals, and gonads. The nervous system is organized into a central nervous system, brain, and spinal cord, a peripheral nervous system, cranial and spinal nerves, and an autonomic nervous system, sympathetic and parasympathetic. There are 10 pairs of cranial nerves arising from the brain. Brain is enclosed in a bony structure called brain box, cranium. The brain is divided into forebrain, midbrain and hindbrain. Forebrain includes olfactory lobes, paired cerebral hemisphere and unpaired diencephalon. The midbrain is characterized by a pair of optic lobes. Hindbrain consists of cerebellum and medulla oblongata. The medulla oblongata passes out through the foramen magnum and continues into spinal cord, which is enclosed in the vertebral column. Frog has different types of sex organs, namely organs of touch, sensory, papillae, taste, taste buds, smell, nasal epithelium, vision, eyes and hearing, tympanum with internal ears. Out of these, eyes and internal ears are well organized structures and the rest are cellular aggregations around the nerve ending. Eyes in a frog are a pair of spherical structures situated in the orbit and skull. These are simple eyes possessing only one unit external ear is absent in frogs and only tympanum can be seen externally. The ear is an organ of hearing as well as balancing equilibrium. Frogs have well-organized male and female reproductive systems. Male reproductive organs consist of a pair of yellowish ovate testes, figure 7.21, which are found adhered to the upper part of kidneys by a double fold of peritoneum called mesotium. Vasa differentia are 10 to 12 in numbers that arise from testes. They enter the kidneys on this side and open into Bider's canal. Finally, it communicates with the urogenital duct that comes out of the kidneys and opens into the cloaca. The cloaca is a small median chamber that is used to pass fecal matter, urine, and sperms to the exterior. The female reproductive organs include a pair of ovaries, figure 7.22. Figure 7.22. Female reproductive system. The ovaries are situated near kidneys and there is no functional connection with kidneys. A pair of oviduct arising from the ovaries opens into the cloaca separately. A mature female can lay 2,500 to 3,000 ova at a time. Fertilization is external and takes place in water. Development involves a larval stage called tadpole. Tadpole undergoes metamorphosis to form the adult. Frogs are beneficial for mankind because they eat insects and protect the crop. Frogs maintain ecological balance because this serves as an important link of food chain and food web in the ecosystem. In some countries, the muscular legs of frogs are used as food by man.
Thank you for being till the end. I hope this has helped you. If so, give thumbs up, like, share, comment, save, download and subscribe. You can support us by following in other platforms. That link is in the description. Well, thank you. See you later. Maybe never.